Welcome back to Disney Springs. We are here checking out some of the new merchandise they have inside World of Disney just to start off our day.
Let's do it.
In the kitchen and home section, we've got this really cool set here. Look at these bowls right here. That's a great one. Mickey's all around, even on the outside. I gotta tell you, I really like the kitchen set when it comes to the Disney items. $39.99 for that. You got the homestead, the plate design kind of matches, and you got the coasters here. I don't know, the home things for Disney, I love it all. You know, Disney's always coming up with new mug designs. Check out Donald Duck mug, that's so cool. $19.99, comes with this Donald. I wonder, oh, it just comes out just like that, okay. So it's just like a topper, but still, maybe keeps your drink nice and warm. First thing in the morning, got coffee in there. I mean, just the appearance alone. Walk around, you know, with this. Yes, please. Unlock your imagination. I feel like I'm seeing a new mug every single time. It's got the key in there. Uses a spoon, $19.99 for this one. Look at that spoon. That is a great one. Check out the Disney watch collection here. We got Stitch, Minnie, look at this. A pumpkin carriage right there. Mickey and Friends, such a great collection of watches here. Of all of these, which one's my, oh, wait a minute, look at this one down here. About to say which one's my favorite. That's pretty cool right there. But there are so many good ones. I think like a classic like this. Just Mickey, hopefully with his hands. Oh wait, here we go, I found it. Mickey with his hands showing the time. There you go, I love that one. I love this hat. Here, you leave today and into the world of yesterday, tomorrow, and fantasy, and it's a medal. It's actually like the sign there. That is a very cool hat. Price of this one, $27.99. That is a cool hat. I have so many hats, I'm trying to restrain myself, but that one has my attention, I'm telling you. The Disney Numios definitely have gotten really popular. You can see Minnie here, but they've added even more. There's Ariel, her own Numio. They're very, very cool. You can give them all sorts of attire, and she does have those human legs right there. So you can give her all sorts of attire that you can find this section right over here. They've also got Piglet and Tigger and Pooh and Eeyore and so many others. You can see all these costumes here for them. They've got the Walt Disney World spirit jerseys there. That's cool. Then they've got the golf outfit. Wait a minute, that's awesome. Those are some cool ears right there. Check it out, Madame Leota. It's kind of got these, what would you call that? Kind of like these buttons on them. Almost look like spikes. Madame Leota in the middle. You can see the safety pins right in between. Very cool. Her universe, look at that. Very cool, the Haunted Mansion. $39.99 for these ears. These are some pretty cool ears here, kind of like this leather. Very, very unique there in this almost, I don't know what you call this, a bow made of other kind of leather. Very cool, $29.99 for these ears. Very cool sweatshirt here, 2021 Walt Disney World. Can't believe I haven't seen this one yet. You can see the inside of the hood has this very cool design. And right there you can see 2021 on the back. I love it. Here's another great hat. Good vibes only with Rafiki. Now that is a great message on a hat. Love that. Price of this one to be determined. $27.99 for this one as well. You can see it says Disney Parks right on the inside there. Now these are some really cool pajama pants here. Oh my gosh, it's great. All right, can you see Grogu? All right, this is great. Look at this. Grogu there in between the stormtroopers from the kind of the different generations of stormtroopers, if you will. Very, very cool. Love these pajama pants. This one is $36.99 for that one. Check out the Disney 24-piece flatware set. Really like that. You can see Mickey right there at the bottom. And they've kind of got this new frosted look to it, where it's the shiny silver here, more of the frosted below. So I think it's a little bit of a new style there. $69.99 for the standard flatware set, but there's even more over here. Here's the 5-piece serving set. Really cool, matches the other one. Got two of these large spoons here, the fork, this kind of bread knife or butter knife, and then the large spatula there. Very, very cool. What is the price of this? It is $40 for this 5-piece set. Now that is great. This is a cutting board set. I did have to double check. And it's got these little tabs here, almost looks like folders. You pull out the cutting board and you've got four individual cutting boards. That is very, very cool. Perfect for separating different items. You want to have like different cutting boards for different items in your house. Very cool. $34.99 for these boards. Something really interesting that I just noticed, the ganache is actually advertising inside World of Disney. You can see it's the Adventurer's Pinata there. You snake on there, a helm, very cool. Surrounded by chocolate all around, $28 for that. But it's here inside of World of Disney. Find these treats and more at the ganachery. That's so cool. Now in recent days here at Walt Disney World, I've noticed a great reduction in the number of people all around. Let's see if that actually translates to other lines. World of Disney definitely felt a little shorter. It's midday, so I'm wondering if the line for Gideon's is actually going to be shorter, too. I feel like it's a good test that Disney Springs for line length.
As we're making our way to Gideon's, I noticed this brand new charm from Pandora. Check that out. Star Wars. So cool. I
was wondering what the virtual wait time is for Gideon's. About 3 hour wait. Okay, good to know. Thank you very much. About a 3 hour wait. I guess it hasn't changed that much here at Gideon's. Love those cookies, though. First thing in the morning. That's how you get into Gideon's. And just like that, we're at Animal Kingdom. It's been a while. Let's go experience it.
You can tell crowds are starting to slow down just a bit in the park. It might look crowded to you right here, but I'm telling you, compared to earlier in the summer, definitely is starting to slow down. Slowly, but surely, slowing down.
30-minute wait for Kilimanjaro Safaris. Let's go check it out. Just learned masks are required in this line, even though we're all totally outside, and on the ride, even though that's totally outside, from what I was just told by a cast member by the entrance.
Every time I'm in this line, I'm seeing something new, like the Kilimanjaro Safaris there, booking office. There's always something new and small details right in this little area right here. We're gonna be on Simba 1 today. There's a poaching alert. There's a tigress right there. Even a map. Oh my gosh, I've never seen this map before. Showing Harambe Wildlife Reserve. That is so cool.
Now, I mentioned in an earlier video how I felt like the lines were reduced here at Walt Disney World. This, you know, it's right to, you know, we don't have fast passes right now anyway. And I'm starting to see that again and again. I was just kind of being confirmed in my mind. As I'm walking in this line here, it said 30 minutes, but this is, from at least this point anyway, definitely not a 30 minute wait. So it does make me think that, again, without fast passes, the lines are slightly shorter. Just confirming this is not a 30 minute wait. So, I don't know, is it related to fast passes or is it just right now? I don't know, but makes me think about it.
All right, let's go see those animals.
Kilimanjaro, saw so many animals. It was super bumpy today, but I was near the back of the safari vehicle, so happens. Bumpier in the back, no question.
Sure enough, the Dawa Bar is open right next to Kilimanjaro Safari. You can see the bar right over here. I have never actually had anything here. Basically, everything they have is alcoholic. I did double check. Definitely a cool spot, though. Sit back, relax, grab a drink, and enjoy these chairs right around. Great for a quick drink. Now, in addition to the Dawa Bar right over there, we've also got Tamu Tamu, which features a cinnamon roll, chocolate twist, guava, and cream cheese Danish, and a honey pistachio croissant. Oh, I'm tempted by all of it. In addition, they've also got the King's Cooler and Simba Sunset, different variations of that Dole Whip there. Definitely want to try that. That sounds amazing.
So I'm going to go with the Simba Sunset, which is Dole Whip pineapple with watermelon, strawberry, and coconut flavored syrup. Never had it before. Can't believe I've never had it before. Let's try it.
Here it is, the Simba Dole Whip. It feels like a hidden secret Dole Whip that you can't find anywhere else. Basically, it is, because I've never seen one of these before here inside of Disney's Animal Kingdom. Are you ready to try it together? I am super excited. Big bite. Bon appetit. That is a very, very unique Dole Whip. Great pineapple flavor, but it's so much more, how do I describe it, airy, frothy, than standard Dole Whip. It's not like soft serve, it's more of a, it's not a slushy, it's just airy soft serve. There's more air pumped into it. You can really tell the difference. If that sounds like something you'd enjoy, first and foremost, that's a unique texture. The watermelon is definitely coming through with the pineapple there as well. I really like it. I really, really do. For those who like the watermelon flavor, again, that is another one that you're not gonna find in a standard Dole Whip. Overall thoughts on the Simba Dole Whip. It's good. I do like it, but you know, I don't love it. The reason is the fluffy flavor. It's again, more air in the soft serve than you would expect. If it was just like standard pineapple Dole Whip with less of the air pumped into it, I feel like I'd like it even more. But I think they try to make it unique, and I feel like, you know, soft serve by itself is fantastic as it is. Like it, don't love it. Would recommend it if you want watermelon and more of a frothy style Dole Whip. Totally your call, of course, but probably one I wouldn't get again, personally. Now, speaking of secret Dole Whips that you can find all around Walt Disney World, Dole Whip has become synonymous with Walt Disney World, and today is the perfect day to talk about all the different kinds that you can find all around Disney World. Now, Disneyland is different. We're talking about Disney World and Disney World Resorts and all those other places, but here on property in Florida. Starting it off first, Aloha Isle at the Magic Kingdom, the standard Dole Whip ice cream, and the Dole Whip float, which I love with vanilla ice cream and pineapple juice. That's one of my favorites. Two standard ones you will continue to find. Others that I'm going to be listing in this video are either like limited time for certain times of year or special events and parties. Let's run through the rest of the list. Sunshine Tree Terrace in Magic Kingdom's got the orange float. Great if you love that orange flavor, of course. Also got the orange cream cup and the I Lava You float. The I Lava You float actually has Dole Whip orange topped with Fanta strawberry and red passion fruit syrup topped with popping candy, a delicious flavor sensation. Marketplace Snacks at Disney Springs has unique ones all the time, the standard Dole Whips, of course. Fresh Dole Whip watermelon slice, that is one that I've been wanting to try. You also got the watermelon parfait version, very, very special. Here at Tamu Tamu in Animal Kingdom, you can find the standard Dole Whip that we know and love. In addition, you can all find, of course, the Simba that we just tried, good, but depends on what you like. In addition, you got the King's Cooler, which is alcoholic. At Trillo Bites, also here at Disney's Animal Kingdom, you can find the Trillo Bite Twist, really good looking one, Dole Whip Orange with vanilla soft serve. At the Barefoot Pool Bar at Disney's Polynesian Village Resort, you can find some unique ones there. The Frosty Pineapple is the Dole Whip blended with rum and frozen margarita Dole Whip lime blended with tequila and chili lime seasoning. Oh my gosh, that's a very unique drink. Of course, Pineapple Lanai, we wouldn't be far. Of course, Pineapple Lanai. Of course, yes. If you're looking to have that Dole Whip on the beach of the Polynesian, this is your spot. You grab a standard Dole Whip or Dole Whip float, and depending on the time of year, they have different ones there, some specialty ones, like different flavors like lime and other ones like orange. From time to time, we've had some super special ones, like celebrating Cinderella and the Lilo and Stitch versions of Dole Whip. It's so cool that they always are thinking of a new style of flavor. Polynesian is where you're gonna go to find a lot of the unique ones. You can find standard Dole Whips and Dole Whip Cone at Blizzard Beach. The Warming Hut's got a very unique one. One of my all-time favorites is one that you can only find during the Halloween season at Walt Disney World. It's called the Poor Unfortunate Souls. This is a very unique Dole Whip that you can only find, again, at Magic Kingdom for Halloween. It's a cherry cola, which is great for like the float part, but it also has a cream cheese soft serve. You think to yourself, Michael, I don't know if that sounds very good. Trust me. One of the all-time best I've ever had. I love it. I would get it every single time. Not kidding. From time to time at Sunshine Tree Terrace, you can find the strawberry flavor just by itself. We were thinking of the Red's Revenge, which is very unique strawberry. Of course, Halloween time at Magic Kingdom is extra special, and they've got the pumpkin one just in time for that time of year. So, again, pumpkin and Poor Unfortunate Souls at the same time. How do you choose between the two? They're both amazing. Poor Unfortunate Souls gets my vote every time. Last but not least, just for the holiday season, they've got the very special chai gingerbread flavor from Aloha Isle. It is out of this world amazing. I am not kidding. Inside the Magic Kingdom is the only place you can get it. I recommend this one. Oh my gosh, just for the holidays. I wish it was year-round. That and Poor Unfortunate Souls, my all-time favorites. So, of course, the standard pineapple float doesn't lose its spot at all. But for specialties, those two I'd go out of my way for every single time. Such a great day today. Thanks so much for sharing it with me. It was so much fun sharing it all with you. Until next time, have a magical day.